Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. So please subscribe to CLJK Bagsik, CLJK Bagsik on my YouTube channel. So story time, and so marami nakakaalam na ako ay na-diagnose ng metastatic prostate cancer last April 26. I think that's the day na officially they or confirm na meron akong metastatic prostate cancer. Then a lot of people were asking what are the symptoms I experienced with prostate cancer. To be honest, dun sa mga symptoms na listed for prostate cancer, wala talaga akong naramdaman dun. Ang only symptom na na-experience ko talaga, it was pain on the back of my right leg. So I remembered na at some point I was like limping at work, and when I searched or googled about the pain on the back of the leg, so na-direct ako sa about sa sciatica. So yun na binasa ko yung about sciatica, na yung symptom na nararamdaman ko talagang symptom siya ng sciatica. So it was way back, if I can remember, it started like January of this year, 2024, on and off siya. Then by February and March, parang every morning nararamdaman ko yung pain sa right leg ko, back of my right leg, or back of my right thigh, I mean. Then I consulted my doctor or GP dito sa UK. This is surgery. So examination, neurological examinations, and sinabi niya na, yeah, that is sciatica, na at some point it will ease off as well, mawawala siya. So advice na exercise or for physiotherapy. So I was referred to physiotherapist. And then I think March as well, ang bilis nung process ng referral nila, nagka-appointment agad ako sa physiotherapist, and yun, nag-exercise, binigyan ako ng mga leaflets or na para sa gentle exercises. And then parang nag-massage din siya, and tinuruan din ako ng mga proper positioning, like laying in bed or how to get out of bed, how to sit down. So at some point, for maybe 3 days, nawala yung pain sa back of my right thigh. So sabi ko, oh wow, mukhang na-improve yung therapy. And on top of that, dahil naka-naproxen naman ako, so continue din yung pag-take ko ng naproxen, na yung namang naproxen ko dati, tinetake ko siya because of my gout. So total, hindi na nag-flare up ang gout ko, na-stop siya, then na-restart ulit yung naproxen because of the pain on the back of my right leg. And then around first week of April, or maybe let's say second week of April, yung pain, so nag sabi ko, bakit parang nag-iba na yung pain? Nag-move na siya sa right hip ko. So sabi ko, bakit? Ganun, I was wondering. Dati yung pain sa right back of my right thigh, nag-move siya sa right hip. So, what I did, nag-continue akong like maybe the naproxen before I'm going to work. I have to take that in the morning and then I have to take another tablet like before going to bed. Then April 18, it was my 50th birthday. So that week, I was on annual leave. But the pain keeps on coming on and off. It's not on my right, not on the back of my right leg anymore. Nandito na siya sa right hip. Sabi ko, something is very, very strange. So, but still, I thought it's still like sciatica. So, I said, anyway, continue with naproxen. Then, 22nd of April, I came back to work with cough. And just started like feeling unwell. So, I said, well, I did my lateral flow test the day before. And I said it was negative. So, I said to my seniors, it's okay for me to come to work. But they're very, very worried. And they said, well, no. Finished what you were doing. It was like, I think around 11 o'clock in the morning or maybe after, let's say after 10 o'clock. They advised me, finish what you're doing and go to A&E. So I went to urgent treatment center and I saw the GP there and then I told the story. And then she said, oh, my chest looks clear, but I need to go for chest x-ray just to confirm and to make sure that everything is okay. But she's more worried about my right hip, why I'm experiencing like kind of moderate to severe pain on my right hip. So she requested bloods and then she said she might request pelvic x-ray as well because maybe there's a fracture. So I had x-ray, I had bloods and hip x-ray as well. And then after a blood test, the consultant saw me and he said, we are worried about the results of the blood, but they did not tell me straight away. So they went for the blood test. I couldn't remember how many requests or blood tests na ginawa sa akin. I think maybe 3 or 4 repeat bloods ang na-request nila. And then until he said, oh, we need to check the tumor markers. I said, kind of what? Tumor markers. So it means na may nakita sila na kind of query na may cancer ako. But they said they need to confirm it first. And then they also requested further scans. Scan ng ating, I think, yeah, scan of my hip. And then they requested MRI as well to confirm. But because yung MRI, they cannot just do it straight away, so they I need an appointment. But with the scan, they did not tell me the results yet because they are waiting or they were waiting for the official results. So if I can remember, it was Friday the 26th of April when I had the appointment for my MRI, and then they told me that I need to go back to see the consultant because they got the results or the official results of the scans. And then after a few minutes I was a little bit anxious already because obviously the pain on my right hip is getting worse day by day. And then the doctor or the consultant told me that with the blood test, PSA, the prostate specific antigen, my PSA level is high. It was like 55, and then the normal value is 0 to 4. And then he told me straight away that you got prostate cancer. So obviously, a bit shocking. And then when they asked me about the symptoms, I told them that the only symptom is sciatic pain. And then they checked the MRI as well, just to confirm. But it's not, there's no official result, but they just check the scan or check the MRI, and then they said, yeah, they can see on the image na prostate cancer siya. So that time, it's like my whole world collapsed. Unbelievable. Prostate cancer na kumalat already sa right hip, and then may nakita rin sa spine ko up to my base of my skull. If I can remember, I think on my clavicle as well, but almost malaki ang na cover o yung pagkalat ng cancer cells. So ang nakaka-worry nga eh about na kumalat sa base ng aking skull. So I was referred to oncologist, to palliative team, and to urologist as well. So that was Friday, and then they said they prescribe Oromorph painkiller as needed to control the pain on my right hip, because I said, I'm so worried that naproxen is not helping me at all. So they prescribe Oromorph, and then they advised me to start using crutches as well, because advice ka nila na kailangan i-rest ko yung right hip ko, kasi i-refer din ako sa trauma and orthopedic. So that day, I went home with crutches. So they just advised me to observe if the pain will ease off with Oromorph, and if it gets worse, I need to go back to hospital. The following Monday, that's the 29th of April, I was hospitalized, went to hospital, because the pain on my right hip, it was unbearable. I experienced very, like a severe pain. As in, I was crying because of the pain. So they admitted me for further examination, for further bloods, and I was seen by palliative team again, seen by trauma and orthopedics. They requested a full bone scan and biopsy as well, to find out na ang primary source talaga is sa prostate. So yeah, and then they gave me as well strong painkillers, yung Somorp. Pinag-Somorp na twice a day, 10 milligrams twice a day, to control the pain, because that's the main concern, controlling my pain. So obviously na-admit ako for few days because continue blood test and then dun sa bone scan dun talaga na nakita yung extent ng cancer cells na kumalat sa katawan ko, na ang most affected talaga yung right hip ko. As in, pinakita sa akin yung image, yung right hip ko talaga, nandun yung pinakamalaking area na black siya. So, doon nag-stay ang cancer cells, pero sa image talaga, puro dot, black na dots doon sa kwan. So, anyway, what can I do? So, the consultant was saying that because I think I got strong immune system, that's why did not feel anything noong kumakalat yung cancer cells. Kasi nga bata pa, and yung katawan ko lumalaban siya sa cancer, pero obviously at some point at that stage hindi ko na nakayanan because of the pain on the right hip. So after I was discharged from hospital, I went to see the uro-oncology nurse to have the first hormone injection, yung Degarelix injection. It was the 22nd of May. And then after a month, 18th of June, I was given Soladex injection dito naman sa surgery sa now given by the practice nurse. And then itong Soladex injection, this is every 3 months, and explain to me this will be a lifetime injection every 3 months. Can you imagine? Every 3 months may injection ako sa aking tummy. And I'm telling you, it's really painful to be honest, because the needle is a bit big. But what can I do? It's part of my treatment. I need to fight for this cancer. June 20, first time na ma-meet ko yung oncologist. So, explain to me, in-explain niya sa akin yung process about the treatment. So, in-explain nga na I need to undergo chemotherapy. And then I ask, how about staging? Anong stage na ng cancer to? Because it was spread already sa katawan ko, mainly sa bones ko, they cannot stage it because it's metastasized already. So, treatment, yun ang chemotherapy, 6 sessions every 3 weeks, and I will have the oral tablets as well, or darolutamide for my prostate cancer. So, yung hormonal tablet ko. So, even natatakot ako that time. Yung anxiety, yung fear, mangyayari sa akin, is my body will, how my body will react sa chemotherapy, sa treatment. Lahat ng worries na talagang pumasok sa isip ko, na naging emotional, naging as in down na down ako that time. Sometimes I have to show a strong face, but deep inside talagang yung couldn't explain it properly, but yung masakit talaga na Bakit nangyari? Bakit ganun? Ang bilis. Cannot imagine na kumalat siyang bigla na ganun kabilis. So, first chemotherapy, my first session was on the 29th of July. So, that was like Monday. I was feeling okay on the day. Second day, okay pa rin. Wednesday, okay. And then Thursday, I started feeling kind of, oh, ito na yung side effect. Yung katawan ko, feeling tired, but not temperature. It's just like, kind of, my body keeps on dragging me to stay in bed. Even though, like, I want to get up to do something, no. Just like, tatayo lang ako for toilet or if I want to eat something. And then, inexplain ng consultant, ng oncologist, binigyan ako ng red card. Ito yung red card na kailangan namin, kailangan siya lagi na hawak-hawak ko. Kasi if I spike temperature of 37.5 and above, or feeling unwell, generally unwell, or shivery or flu-like, I need to contact them, and so that they can advise me to go to hospital because I need to have blood test, I need to have the IV fluids and IV antibiotic straight away, precautionary measures because alam naman natin na kapag nakikimotherapy, mababa ang immune system mo. So, to make sure na wala akong infection and parang precautionary measures na antibiotic, IV fluids, bloods, and then para makita nila kung neutropenic ka. So, ayun. Kaya may red card ako na ipapakita sa A&E para i-prioritize nila and alert ang mga staff na chemo patient ako. And then, so, yung pagiging annual ko ng first chemo, isang araw lang yun. Then, the following day, I felt fine, back to normal, I can do everything again. And then, second chemotherapy ko, on the 19th of August. So, 22. So, nung 22nd ng August, that was Thursday, I became unwell again. I started having temperature and then I felt like kind of like a lump and painful lump dun sa back side ng back passage ko. Sabi ko, oh, something's wrong. So I went again to A&E. So further test, and then I was referred to surgical team, and then had the, I think MRI. I couldn't remember if it's MRI or if it was I think it's just a scan. I couldn't remember. But anyway, they found out that I have the perianal abscess. I said, oh my goodness. So, I need to stay in the hospital. And then I went through surgery. They've done the incision and drainage. They put seton to help reduce the infection plus to drain the abscess. So I said, oh my goodness, another agony. So anyway, I stayed in the hospital for I think 3 days. And then second chemotherapy on the 9th of September. again, so that's the third chemotherapy. Naging unwell again ako na, so Monday, it's the same pattern eh. So Monday chemotherapy, then nagiging unwell ako ng either Wednesday ng gabi or Thursday or Friday. So yun, na-admit ulit ako sa hospital kasi nga nag-spike temperature na naman ako. So the same procedure, IV fluids, IV antibiotic, then bloods, then bloods were okay anyway. And then I went home with oral antibiotics. And then on the 10th of September, I had the second Soladex injection. Fourth chemotherapy noong 30th of September. Naging unwell na naman ako. So 30, then October 1, 2. October 1, Wednesday. No, September 31. October 2, Wednesday. Feeling unwell ako noon. But no temperature. I said, well, I'm not going to hospital. I just like feeling rough. Then Thursday, appointment with the oncologist. And I said, well, I was feeling unwell the day before, but on that day, I was so surprised. I was okay. Then the following Saturday, nag-spike naman akong temperature. Sabi ko, ah, very unusual. Usually, one day lang ako nagiging unwell. Tapos, nag-jump siya na Saturday. So, I went again to the hospital. Again, same procedure. IV fluids, IV antibiotic. Then, bloods taken again. It was all normal. So, they sent me home with oral antibiotic for precaution. Other side effects ng chemo. So, hindi naman talaga severe na experience ko yun. Katulad ng sweating at night, sleeping pattern at night, kind of, it varies. Sometimes, nakakatulog ako, but sometimes, on and off yung sleeping pattern ko. Metallic taste. So until now, andun pa rin yung metallic taste. So kahit anong sarap ng pagkain, hindi ko nalalasahan yan. Ang nalalasahan ko lang talaga ay yung mga maaasim. So yung mga like mga fruits. Then, kapag nagluluto ako, I added more vinegar. If vinegar is part of the ingredients, para malasahan ko yung asim. They were asking, bakit yung ibang nag-chemotherapy, pumapayat sila? To be honest, because I'm on prednisolone as well, so steroids. So, I think yun ang... yun ang dahilan kung bakit lumolobo ako, nagiging chubby ako because of prednisolone. Appetite, darating yung point na wala kang lasa, wala talaga yung appetite mo, pero nasa isip ko, no, I need to eat because my body needs energy. So almost the same lang naman yung amount ng kinakain ko even nung before, bago ako ma-diagnose, pero kasi nga ng steroids, kaya tumataba ako. Emotions, yun talaga ang na masabi ko na malaki ang naging epekto sa akin. Kasi darating talaga na yung time na yung peak ng very emotional ka. Nag-iisa ka minsan, bigla na natutulong yung luha ko kasi yung emotionally unstable talaga na ang dami-daming na inaiisip about you, about sa cancer, sa nangyayari sa akin, parang yun nga, as in bumaliktad talaga yung mundo ko. Then after naiiyak yun, okay na ulit ang pakiramdam. Minsan sa gabi, lalo na ng mga I think first 2-3 sessions ko, sa gabi minsan nagigising na lang ako na napapaiyak talaga ako. Parang umiiyak na lang ako na for out of nowhere talagang mararamdaman mo yung emotions ko. And then yung pa rin na matindi din yung emotions, like the night before ng chemotherapy, lalo na nung first and second, kasi nga yung anxiety, yung fear, na basta ang hirap, it's difficult to explain kasi iba't iba talaga yung emotion. Basta darating na lang siyang bigla, iiyak na lang talaga, down na down ka talaga. So my experience nga talaga sa chemotherapy, like parang naging same pattern siya eh. So Monday yung chemotherapy, at yung week na yun talaga, ang body ko talaga parang nagiging mahina siya. To the point na yung Thursday or Friday, dun nga yung nagiging unwell. Then the following week, mag-start na lang, tumataas na yung energy level ko. Then third week, yan, full of energy talaga ako yung tagang, oh, malakas na malakas. So that's why I keep on telling to my wife, let's go out, go there, London, shopping, eating out, this and that. Because I know na, the following week, yung may chemo session na naman ako, ang katawan ko, going downhill. So yung chemo sessions ko ay every 3 weeks. So, nag-improve na yung pain sa right hip ko. Hindi na siya kasing sakit kumpara dati. Pero, sumasakit pa rin siya paminsan-minsan. Mostly, sa gabi. Kasi obviously, during the day, walking up and down. And it gets tired. And yung latest hip x-ray ko, sabi ng TNO, it improved a lot, but still at risk of obviously if I for example nahulog or nag-trip or na out of balance, the risk is still there. So okay, I still to continue using crutches for the time being. So tomorrow, Monday, so it's my 5th chemotherapy. And then after that, 6th chemo, and that's it. So I'm glad the session will be over soon. And thanks God, yung latest PSA level ko is already normal. So yung latest ay 2.0. Thanks God. So this is the treatment record. Dito ko inire-record pati yung mga side effects na nararamdaman ko. So may scoring yan. Tapos nandito din yung blood test results. So chemo ko is Monday, so the Friday before that chemo session, blood test ako. para make sure I'm fit for the next session. Ayun, so thank you very much for listening. And what I can advise, like the when I asked the consultant about, obviously, kailangan ba natin na yung PSA natin laging i-check. So the advice na, or he advised na, if you reach like 50 years old, if you don't have symptoms, it's advisable na kayong mga lalaki, tayo mga lalaki na i-check yung PSA level natin. So the best advice I can give to you is kung wala kayong history ng cancer sa family ninyo, at wala, kahit wala kayong nararamdaman, if you reach 50, speak to your GP para ma-request kayo ng i-check yung PSA level ninyo. So this video is mainly for awareness about prostate cancer. Based on my experience, as in, yun nga lang, sciatic pain ang aking symptoms. So, hindi man masama magpa-check ng PSA. At least, kapag normal, may assurance na, okay, normal naman, walang problema. Eh, what if mangyari sa inyo ang nangyari sa akin na wala nga yung mga symptom. Pero the doctor said, yeah, it happened, or they had patients as well before na no symptom ng prostate cancer. So it's better to be checked. At least for prevention, at early stage, ma-start na yung treatment ninyo. And then he also advised na yung mga anak nyo, lalaki, if you got, for example, katulad ko, prostate cancer, so my son needs to have his PSA level when he reach 40 years old, just for the safe side. So, ayun, life goes on. Kaya nga, doon sa mga vlog ko or sa TikTok ko, cancer ka lang, Pilipino ako. Malakas ang fighting spirit. Laban, 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 laban. Kahit emotionally damaged at times, lumalaban. Para sa pamilya. So, thank you very much for watching. And I'm hoping na kahit medyo mahaba tong video na to, may mapulot kayong aral. Ah, before I forget pala, simula nung ma-diagnose ako ng prostate cancer, I stopped eating sweets, cakes, sugary drinks. Yung soft drinks talaga, in-stop ko completely, or fizzy drinks dito sa UK. So talagang ang ininom ko lang ay water, coffee, or cup of tea. Soft drinks talaga, stop completely. It's a no-no for me. Cakes, chocolates, ako pa naman ako. Ang hilig kong kumain ng cakes, chocolate. Talagang yan ang pag nag-crave ako, buy ako ng chocolates dyan sa kahit sa, basta any chocolates. Paborito ko talaga yan, kahit nasa work. Minsan magdadala ako ng tin of chocolates and share. But now, no, because I read as well na ang cancer cells likes sugar. kuan yan, kanilang energy yan. So na create na tag ito. Kung kumain ka ng chocolate or any sweets, okay, craving satisfied, pero mas satisfied ang cancer cells. Lumalaki sila dahil sa sugar. So ako naman, ang coffee ko at saka tea, kahit nung paman, wala ng sugar talaga yan. So yun, yun ang good thing as well. Hindi na ako kumakain ng chocolates, hindi na ako kumakain ng cakes. Pero isang beses, nun talagang, birthday ni Mrs., talagang siguro, as in nag-crave talaga ako ng cake. Kasi bumili kami ng cakes, sabi ko. Talaga sabi ko, oh, cheat day ko talaga to. Sabi ko, patikim na ako ng konting cake. As in talagang konti lang, tumikim lang talaga ako para lang, minsan talaga at some point na mag-crave ka talaga. Pero after that, hindi na ulit. So okay, thank you very much for watching. And I'm hoping na this video, this vlog, will serve as kind of like lessons or awareness na about prostate cancer. So yeah, it can happen to any man age 40 or even younger or even below 40. Pero ako nga, 50 years old, turned 50 years old in April. And then a week later, diagnosed with metastatic prostate cancer. So yeah, thank you very much for watching, and keep on like watching my blog, my future blogs. Please share as well and like CLJK Bagsi. Love you guys. And thank you, Lord, because matatapos na ang treatment ko, and sana magtuloy-tuloy na ang paggaling ko. And shout out to all my friends, to my family, for all the help, prayers, and talagang that's my biggest weapon, yung prayers. It's multicultural faith, to be honest. Ang daming like different religions, cultures, or different iba't ibang religions talaga, mga friends and colleagues na nagsusupport or nagpe-pray for my recovery. Without you guys, siguro, I don't know where I will be at kung wala yung mga prayers ninyo. So again, love you guys and thank you for watching. Bye.